Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemeds. Today we are discussing about the topic acid rain. Acids, mainly nitric acid and sulfuric acid, are formed in the atmosphere from the air pollutants, nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides.
Diseases in human beings and animals.
They are brought down into the earth as constituents of rain, snow, fog, etc. That is the wet deposition, or as being incorporated into dust, smoke, etc. That is dry deposition. This acid deposition on earth's surface is called acid rain. That is, acid rain is occurs due to either by wet deposition or dry deposition. We have known that the normal rainwater pH is 5.6 due to the presence of H plus ions formed by the reaction between rainwater and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere. That is, water react with the carbon dioxide and to form carbonic acid, and then carbonic acid decomposes to give H plus and bicarbonate ion. This H plus ion is responsible for the acidity of rainwater. That is, with the presence of nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides causes the pH of the rainwater to drop down below 5.6, and it is called acid rain. Do you know how to form acid rain? Tremendous amounts of nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides are released into the atmosphere as a result of the combustion of fossil fuels. These pollutants are converted into nitric acid and sulfuric acid through a series of chemical reactions. In the presence of light, water, oxygen, heavy metal ions, organic oxidants in the atmosphere. And these acids came down to the earth surface through rain, snow, fog, etc. and constitute what is known as acid rain. It is thus a major secondary effect of air pollution. At first, nitrogen oxide combined with the oxygen and to form NO2, nitrogen dioxide. Then the formed nitrogen oxide combines with the oxygen and water and to form nitric acid. The another method for the formation of nitric acid is NO react with the ozone and to form NO2 and oxygen. In the second step, the formed NO2 again react with the ozone and to form NO3 and O2. NO3 again combines with NO2 and to form N2O5. N2O5 react with the water and to form nitric acid. This is the second method for the formation of nitric acid in the atmosphere. Then we can discuss about the formation of sulfuric acid in the atmosphere. This occurs in a number of feasible ways. The process may be catalytic one. The catalyst may be heavy metal ions present in the atmosphere, or it may involve a number of radical. The overall process may be represented as sulfur dioxide react with oxygen and water and to form sulfuric acid. The acid droplets formed in the air get suspended in water vapors and to form acid fog, which gets dispersed far and wide by air currents. In a cool weather, the acid fog precipitates acid rain. Do you know what are the adverse effects of acid rain? Acid rain have severe ecological impacts and is a serious problem in several areas. The acid droplets in the air, as well as acid contaminated potable water, cause respiratory, neurological and digestive
diseases in human beings and animals.
Acid rain causes corrosion of pipes, leading to the leaching of heavy metals such as iron, lead and copper into the drinking water. This is extremely hazardous to the consumers of such polluted water. acid rain dissolves and washes away the nutrients needed for the growth of plants and trees, and also increases the acidity of the soil and thereby causes serious damage to the plants and agricultural crops. Further, the cadmium absorption of plants increases and posing a serious health problem to plants and animals. It damages the leaves of trees, reduces the photosynthesis capability and retarded their growth, thereby destroying forest. Thus, the natural resource for the production of wood, wood pulp, paper, etc. are decreased. The another adverse effect is acid rain make the water in tanks, ponds, lakes and rivers too much acidic, that fish and other aquatic organisms are eliminated in such regions. The acid droplets in air as well as acid rain causes extensive damage to buildings, monuments, statues, etc. For example, acid rain reacts with marble, that is calcium carbonate react with sulfuric acid and to form calcium sulfate. As a result, the structure becomes pitted as the soluble salts formed are leached out by rainwater. The Taj Mahal in Agra also faces an acid rain threat. Acid rain also destroys the materials like fabric, paper, etc. These are the adverse effects of acid rain. Now, how to control acid rain? The short-term control of acid deposition problem can be achieved by using lime in acid polluted soils and freshwater bodies. However, this is not a solution for the acid rain problem. It can only decrease the acidity of the soil or freshwater bodies. The only remedy to prevent the acid rain is to reduce the formation of nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides. This needs basic changes in the pattern of using fossil fuels, and also required to reduce the emission of sulfur oxides and nitrogen oxides into the atmosphere. Solar energy should be used wherever possible instead of fossil fuels. These are the control measures for acid rain.